Hello friends, my name is Tripti Mishra and I am your instructor for today. I will be discussing cybersecurity techniques part 1 with all of you. The last type of user authentication technique is biometric authentication. Biometric authentication attempts to authenticate an individual based on his or her unique physical characteristics. Physical characteristics can be static or dynamic. Static characteristics include fingerprints, hand geometry, facial characteristics, and retinal and iris patterns, and dynamic characteristics such as voice, iris, and signature. In essence, biometric is based on pattern recognition. Compared to passwords and tokens, biometric authentication is both technically complex and expensive. While it is used in a number of specific applications, biometrics has yet to mature as a standard tool for user authentication to computer systems. Best example of biometric authentication is Aadhaar card that uses fingerprint and iris scan characteristics to uniquely identify a person in India. It uses combination of various algorithms to do so. Biometrics can be divided into two categories: physiological and behavior. Physiological includes fingerprint, iris, retina, face, hands, voice, DNA, etc. Whereas behavioral includes signature, keystroke, etc. Examples are fingerprint in mobile device to authenticate you. This is physiological, right? What if a user is authenticated to access a system in future with the help of his typing speed? So a lot can be done in this area to enhance the security of a system. Let us see how the biometric authentication process takes place. The user database contains a sample of users' biometric characteristics. This is the initial phase. During authentication process, the user is required to provide a new sample of the user's biometric at runtime. This sample is sent for encryption. This current sample is decrypted and compared. If the sample matches, user is considered as a valid one, that is authentic, otherwise unauthentic. This was simple, right? Applications of biometric authentication. Several applications of biometrics are already in use. In commercial environments, these include access to facilities, access to information systems, transaction at point of sales, and employee timekeeping. In the law enforcement system, they include investigations using fingerprints or DNA and forensic analysis. Border control and immigration control also use some biometric techniques. Let's have a look at it. The figure describes a typical simplified workflow of an automatic border control system, eGate, using an electronic passport of a citizen. E-passport is first scanned using scanner contactless reader. Border control system then checks for security features in e-passport. Then the chip is read for data authentication. At last, biometric verification is performed by face recognition system. If everything matches, the document is valid and the citizen is allowed. Benefits of biometric authentication. They are highly secure. We cannot forge the physical characteristics of any individual, so reduces the chance of forgery. Drawbacks of biometric authentication. They're complex to manage. To process the information or data, they require costly, expensive tools. Different challenges occur during the processing of information. For example, let's say front face is stored in database and we get the face that is non-frontal. Then the system will not be able to detect the face. Elimination problem will occur. Or let's say you used to authenticate your mobile with your fingerprint, which is a little bit damaged due to cuts and marks on it. Your phone might not be able to identify you. Authentication is not limited to user level. Authentication is required in distribution systems as well. Single sign-on, SSO, is a user session authentication process that permits a user to enter one name and password in order to access multiple applications. The process authenticates the user for all the applications they have been given rights to and eliminates further prompts when they switch applications during a particular session. The best example of SSO is Gmail. When you log on to your Gmail account, you can access YouTube, Google Photos, Google Plus, Calendar, Photos, Map, etc. You don't need to log into each application separately. You are authenticated to access all the applications by signing into one account. But it has a disadvantage too. If an attacker gets hold of your password, he can access data stored on all the applications. Here, figure shows that a person uses firewall and SSO system to access email, HR information, corporate intranet, and client extranet, and whatnot. Challenges in authentication. There are various challenges while authenticating a person. First, collection of authenticating data, that is, storing ID and password of all users securely. Second, transmitting the data securely. That is, if we want to access any resource, first we have to enter user ID and password for authenticating oneself. Then those credentials are transmitted through a channel or network to the server. And after the verification done by the server, one is authorized to access that resource. In this condition, one's credentials should pass through a secure channel, otherwise it will be misused. The third challenge in authentication is to ensure that whether the person who was originally authenticated is still the person using the computer system or not. Like in bank website, there is a session timeout. That is, if the system is idle for some time, then you will have to again enter your credentials to authenticate yourself.